हेलो स्टूडेंट, आई एम दीपक महाले। टुडे आई एम स्टार्टिंग द न्यू लेक्चर सीरीज फॉर एलिमेंट्स ऑफ मशीन डिज़ाइन। इन दिस वीडियो आई विल इंट्रोड्यूस व्हाट इज मशीन डिज़ाइन। आफ्टर कंप्लीटिंग दिस वीडियो स्टूडेंट विल एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज एलिमेंट ऑफ मशीन डिज़ाइन एंड व्हाट इज द जनरल डिज़ाइन प्रोसीजर टू डिज़ाइन द प्रोडक्ट और मैन्युफैक्चर द प्रोडक्ट। These are the content for this video. First is introduction to machine design. Second one is general procedure involved in machine design. Third one is general consideration in machine design. And fourth one is basic design requirements. Now we will start introduction of machine design. What is machine design? Machine design is the use of scientific principles, technical information and imagination in the description of a machine or mechanical system to perform specific function. In simple words, we can say that for designing a machine, we have to imagine that machine into our mind or a product which is we have to design, and after that apply the scientific principle on it and technical information which we have studied in previous subjects. We have to apply that information onto it and produce the design for the product. Machine design refers to create new and better machines along with the improvement and updation of existing machines. Figure shows the flow chart. From the flow chart, we see that first in the first box, recognition of need. For what use the product is to be manufactured or machine is to be manufactured, we have to recognize the need of that product. After that, apply the scientific principles, technical information, and also apply which material is to be used for manufacturing that product, behavior of that material, and theory of stresses which are applied at the time of use of that product. After that, applying that principles, we have to create a design. After creating a design, we will produce a prototype model for it. Prototype model means we have seen a ship in a different exhibition which they show us a prototype model of naval ships in Navy exhibition and other exhibition. Different types of prototype models are manufactured to showcase. At the time of design also, firstly the prototype model is made, and after that testing is done on it, different types of software or with the different types of tools. After testing, we get the feedback from that testing, and we will improve the design, and again the design is created and a prototype model is created. Again prototype model is created with the new improvement in it. After final testing, the product description, its detailed drawing is given to the production department for the production. This is the simple flowchart for the machine design. In the machine design, as per the needs and demands of the consumer, small scale units, machines are invented or modified by creating an idea in the mind. This idea is then reform and translated in terms of dimensions and suitable drawings. Now we will see general design procedure or steps involved in designing a machine component. In that there are 8 steps. First step is need or aim. In this step we have to recognize the need of that product or machinery for what use it is to be manufactured. With the complete problem statement and indicating the need, aim or purpose of the machine for which it is to be designed. In next step, mechanism. Select the possible mechanism or group of mechanism which will give the desired motion. We have seen in the theory of machine subject what are the mechanism. From that we have to select the possible mechanism for the design purpose. After that, next step is analysis of forces. Find the forces acting on the each member of the machine. For example, if we manufacture a chair for a small children, we have to consider the weight of that children and size of that children. That chair cannot be used for the older person because older person weight is more. In this type, we have to analyze the forces for different type of machine and different types of product which we have to design. Next, material selection. Select the most suitable material for each member. Means, if we choose a plastic material for a crane hook, it will not sustain the weight of the product which the crane is lifting. For that, we have to select a more harder material to sustain that stresses which are coming on the crane hook. Next step is design of machine element. Find the size of each member by considering forces acting on the member and permissible stresses for the selected material from the design data book. Next step is modification. Modify the size of member to agree with the past experience of our skilled worker or skilled design engineer by judgment to reduce the overall production cost to benefit the manufacturer or an organization. Next step is detailed drawing. Draw the detailed drawing of the each component and assembly of the machine with the complete specification for the manufacturing process. After detailed drawing is created, that drawings are given to the production department to manufacture the product with the information of which material is to be used and which manufacturing process is to be used to manufacture that product. These are the 8 steps for designing the product or a component. Now we will see general consideration in machine design. In that, first consideration, type of externally applied loads and stresses induced in the machine element. Externally applied loads on the machine component may act in several ways. Component tries to resist these loads, due to which internal stresses are induced in the component. Next consideration is mechanism. In this consideration, motion of the parts or kinematics of machine is considered. Successful operation of any machine depends largely upon the simplest arrangement of parts which will give the required motion. Next consideration is selection of material. Designer should have a deep knowledge of properties of material and their behavior under working condition. Working condition are like the hot temperature or a cold temperature, and the properties are like strength, durability, flexibility, weight, resistance to heat and corrosion, castability, weldability, hardenability and machinability, etc. After that, convenient and economical feature. Machine design must be convenient to operate and cost-wise economical for the customer to purchase. Next consideration is use of standard parts. Use of standard parts reduces the overall cost. Standard parts like nut and bolt, small parts that are standard by the universal organization which will produce in a mass production from the other vendor, that will reduce the overall cost of the product. Next is safety of operation. To avoid the accidental hazard, care should be taken by designer against all the possibilities of dangerous situation at the time of worker uses that machine or a product. Next is workshop facilities. A design engineer should be familiar with the limitations of employer's workshop. More number of parts is to be manufactured in our organization with the available machinery. By that, the designer should change the manufacturing process to manufacture that part if possible. Next is number of machines to be manufactured. Designer should consider in mind at the time of design what number of parts or machine is to be manufactured into the company. By that, the simple manufacturing process or a machine which is required to manufacture that product is to be purchased from the other industry for manufacturing that number of machines to give the maximum profit to the manufacturer. Next is cost of production. Design engineer should always be designed a part, product or a machine in a such a way that production cost will be less. This benefits manufacturer as well as customer. By the product cost is less, the customer will buy the product by the customer, the profit will be gained to the manufacturer. Next, age of assembly. All the components should be easy to assemble for creating a machine. Simplicity in design should be priority for any design engineer. Means we have to manufacture that part with consideration that after the assembly, at the time of assembly, it should be assembled easily, not take much time or much process, which will be considered in the mind. Last consideration is frictional resistance and lubrication. Designer should provide necessary lubrication to all moving parts of machine. Movements may be sliding, rolling, rotary or reciprocating, etc. These are the general consideration at the time of machine design. Now we will see basic design requirements. There are different requirements for design. First is strength. A machine part should not fail under the effect of externally applied loads or forces acting on it. It should have sufficient strength to avoid the failure either due to the fracture or due to the general yielding. Next requirement is rigidity. A machine component should be rigid, that is, it should not deflect or bend too much due to forces, that is, it should not deflect or bend too much due to the forces or bending moment acting on it. Next is wear resistance. Machine parts worn out very early as compared to their expected life due to wear. Wear also leads to the loss of accuracy of machine tools. Wear resistance of any machine parts can be increased by increasing its hardness. For example, case of hardening of gears and cams. By hardening, the strength of the gears and cams is increased. Next is manufacturability. Manufacturability is the age of production, lubrication and assembly. Shape and material of machine part should be selected in such a way that it can be produced easily with minimum labor and material cost. Next is safety. Shape and dimension of machine parts should be ensure safety to the operators of the machine who is working on it at the time of design. Next is standardization. A machine part should be conformed to national or international standard covering its profile, dimensions, grade and material used. Standard products, for example, like our electricity plug or a nut and bolt assembly, which are the standard product. Next is reliability. Reliability is defined as the probability of a machine part that will give satisfactory performance over the sufficient time period. Any machine parts can be called as a reliable if it perform its functions under the desired operating condition over a specified period of time. Next is machinability. A machine part should be machinable. Machinability is the age with which a machine parts can be serviced or repaired. Machinability is defined as the probability that a product will be restored to its operational effectiveness within the given period when maintenance action is carried out as per the prescribed procedure mentioned in the service manual. These are the basic design requirements for the machine design. Now, in this video, we have seen what is machine design, what is the general steps involved in machine design, and also general consideration for machine design. And last, we have seen the basic requirements in the machine design. In the next video, we will see the types of loads, types of stresses, which are to be considered at the time of machine design. Thank you.